operation of our nuclear.
Defense Department Undersecretary James Miller told the Senate Foreign Relations Committee that the New START treaty will not limit the U.S. from developing a missile defense system to guard against missile attacks by Iran, North Korea, or any other country.
The New START treaty does not constrain the United States from deploying the most effective missile defense as possible, nor does it add any additional cost or inconvenience. It enables this president and his successors to develop the missile defenses needed to defend the nation, our deployed forces abroad, and our allies and partners from the threat of ballistic missile attack.
The treaty, if ratified by both sides, would reduce U.S. and Russian nuclear arsenals by 30%, leaving each side with about 1,500 strategic nuclear weapons. But opposition Republican Party Senator James Reich expressed doubts. He asked Patrick O'Reilly, the director of the Missile Defense Agency, if Russia believed that under the treaty the U.S. could not defend itself or its allies using certain missile defense systems.
Would you agree with me that that's what their unilateral statement says?
My understanding of the statement is that we would not develop a ballistic missile defense systems to counter their strategic balance of forces with us. The treaty does not limit my ability to develop the most cost-effective missile defenses possible.
The Pentagon officials also told lawmakers that the longer it takes Washington to ratify the new arms control treaty with Moscow, the greater the uncertainty with understanding Russia's strategic weapons systems. Chris Simpkins, VOA News, Washington.